Hello everybody and welcome back to my kitchen. Today we're going to make some beautiful cheesy vegetable pasties. I've got everything that I need ready. Let's take a look. I've got my potato and onion. I've got the vegetables I've chosen, some peas and carrots. I have my cheese, pastry, cutting board, fork, cutting knife, and peeler. And ready for when I'm going to cook, I've got my pan, microwave container, and my egg flipper. Right, well, let's get cooking. The first thing that we're going to need to do is prepare our vegetables. I'm going to peel and chop my carrot and potato first. Okay, I have peeled my vegetables and it's time to chop them up. I want to chop them up into small pieces because the smaller that they are, the less time it takes for them to cook. So look at the size of your potato. You want about the same amount of other vegetables as you have of potato. My carrot's not very big, so I'm going to chop all of it up. But if you have a very big carrot, you might want to only use half of it. Put that in your microwave bowl. Time to cut the potato. We're cooking them all together, so cut the potato around about the same size as you've cut your carrot. I like to cut mine into chip sizes like that, and then I cut it this way to make small little pieces. Carrot and potatoes ready to cook in the microwave, so I'm going to add a little bit of water and put them in the microwave for about 3 minutes, and then I'll check and see if they're cooked enough or if they need a little bit more time. Okay, let's check these vegetables. Open very carefully. Very carefully. Look how hot that is. Taking my fork and poking it in. Now, my potatoes are still pretty firm, so I think they're only about half cooked. But you might have noticed I didn't put my peas in. That's because peas don't take as long to cook. So I think this is a good time to add my peas into my microwave container now. There we go. And now they can cook along with the other vegetables. I'm going to put it in for another 3 minutes, I think. That's finished, take two. Let's check and see how cooked they are. Once again, we need to be really careful when we're opening a hot container that's come out of the microwave. Notice that I'm going to open it away from my body so that the steam goes over there and not near me. There we go. I can poke my fork right through those nice and easily so they're cooked. Now to help it cool off a bit, I'm going to run it under some cold water and then drain the cold water off and then leave my vegetables to keep cooling off while I start chopping my onions. Okay, I'll put those aside and it's time to start chopping my onion. This isn't a very big recipe, so I don't need a lot of onion. I'm going to make 2 tablespoons of chopped onion and then I'm going to cook them in the pan. Well, let's see how much I've got. 1 tablespoon, put that aside for later. Another tablespoon. There we go. Okay, that's how much onion I'm going to use for this recipe. It's time to cook my onion now, so that means it's time to turn the stove on. I'm going to put it on a high heat. Up as high as it can go. Put my pan on the hot plate and spray a little bit of oil in so that my onion doesn't stick to the pan and to help it cook really nicely. Now while I'm waiting for my pan to heat up, that's a really good time to take my fork and start to mash my vegetables up a little bit. I don't need too much mashing, just a little bit of a squish. I think that's looking pretty good. I might go and check on my pan. Now if I put my hand about here at a nice safe distance, I can feel that the heat is coming up. So I know it's ready and my pan is hot enough to start cooking. Onions in. You can see how hot it is now, can't you? Stir them around. You can see that some of them are starting to look a little bit see-through and they're starting to look a little bit soft and see-through. They're ready to go into your mixture. So this is the time when we put everything in together, our onion, our cheese. If you want anything extra, you can. Even a bit of salt and pepper. I'm going to add some salt and pepper to mine. Okay, so in go the onions. In goes the cheese. I used 1/4 cup of cheese. You can use as much or as little as you want. I just love cheese, so I usually have a bit more. A bit of salt, a bit of pepper, and mix it all up. Looking really nicely mixed up now, so I'm ready to move on to the pastry. If you wanted to have a little bit of extra moisture, you could add some butter to this mixture if you wanted. Now cut your pastry in half. We're going to use 1 strip for every pasty. So 1/2 sheet of pastry is 1 pasty. For this step, you need your pastry, your fork, your mixture with a spoon and a little bit of milk. You also need your baking tray with some greaseproof paper on it and your oven preheated, so it's time to switch on your oven to 180 degrees. We're up to the fun bit now. It's time to assemble our pasty. We're going to spoon our mixture onto 1/2 of this piece of pastry. go. I'm going to put a little bit of milk around the edges, just with my finger. My hands are really nice and clean. I've been washing them this whole time. Okay. Close my pasty over. Squish it down. Now this is why we have the fork. We need to use the fork to press the two slices of pastry together so that they don't pop open when they're cooking. Just like that. The next thing, use your milk again to just rub over the top. And finally, we want to allow the steam to get out while it's cooking. So we just poke some holes in it, and that is ready to go on my baking tray. And then you just do it all again until you run out of mixture. I managed to get 3 pasties out of my mixture, so I'm going to put them in the oven right now. Cook your pasties in the oven for 20 minutes or until they're golden brown. Time to check on my pasties. Oh, they look perfect. Time to come out of the oven. I'm using my oven mitt so that I'm nice and safe and I don't hold anything that's hot. Close my oven, switch it off. And look at that finished product. Let your pasty cool down for a while because it will be hot, hot, hot. And then use your flipper to dish it up. And voila, lunch is served. I think it's time for me to say that cooking time is finished and lunch time is beginning. I'll see you next time. Bye.